Today class to go for the constructor of concept. Every day want to talk to you personally. Can you call to your personal number? Yeah, you can call me after 11 o'clock. Okay, I'll talk to you, Sukumar. Regarding? Okay, good. Regarding course, okay, we will see. See guys, every day we are creating object, right? So if you take the class, class name is called test class. For the test class, we'll create the object, like how to create the object, guys. Test t equal new test, right? This is like object creation line, right? Exactly. Guys, in this object creation line, basically test is a class name. Okay, test is a class name. And what about t here? T is object name, basically. Okay, test is a class name. T is basically like, okay, object name. T is object name, guys. What about new here? New is a keyword to create the object. Okay, new is a keyword to create the object. After new keyword, this part is called constructor, basically. So in entire Java, after new keyword, that part is called basically constructor part, guys. Guys, that point is clear. Test t equal new test means test is a class name, t is the object name, new is a keyword to create the object. Test of this part is called which part, guys? Simply here constructor, right? Guys, that part is called constructor. Sir, we know method syntax is a null. What is the rules to declare the constructor? Guys, first of all, check the syntax of the constructor. Rules to declare the constructor, right? Exactly. So what are the rules we have to follow? Rule one. So method name can be anything, guys. You can take any method name, but the constructor name, class name must be same. Okay. Constructor name, constructor name and what the class name must be same, right? Exactly, guys. The rule one is like constructor name, class name must be same. Okay, good. Rule two, even constructor can take the argument, guys. Constructor can take the arguments, right? Method can take the arguments, constructor also can take the arguments. And the method is having return type, right? Guys, methods are having return type, right? Constructors are return type is not allowed, guys. Even void also. Constructor return type is not allowed, even void also not allowed, guys. So constructor, okay, return type not allowed, even void, okay, even void, guys. So constructor name, class name should be same, must be same. Constructor can take the arguments. Constructor return type is allowed or not allowed means Return type not allowed, right? Exactly, guys. See, if you take the class, class name is called test class. Inside the class, if I want to declare a zero argument constructor, so the syntax wise here, constructor name, class name must be same. Can take the zero argument here, open this, close the brace. Here we can put the logics, right? That's it. So inside the class, if I want to declare the one argument constructor, the syntax is what? Constructor name, class name must be same. Arguments, can I take like integer A, one argument? Just open this closer brace. Here you can put the logics, right? Exactly, guys. Is it clear now? So class test, this is like zero argument constructor. Class, like this is like one argument constructor, right? Exactly. Guys, these are rules to declare the constructors, basically. Rules to declare the constructor, right? Good. See, guys, for example, if you take the class, class name is called test class. Class name test class. Inside the class, I can declare the void, void wish method is there. Inside the wish method, simply can write the message like system.out.println. Simply like you can write the message like good morning message, guys. In this case, to call that method, which method it is, instance or static method? It's instance method. How can we call the instance method? We can call the instance method object, right? So test t equal to new test, then we have to call the t dot wish method, right? Exactly. T dot wish method we have to call. Okay, good. Can I see this code here? So the class name is called test class. Class name is called test class. Just open the command prompt, local disk E, CLS, Java. So the application is called what? Test dot Java. Code is compiled fine. But see, guys, here test in the execution starts from main method. In the main method, what's the first line here? Test t equal new test, right? After new keyword, this part is called which part here? Constructor, right? Guys, tell me, but inside the class, do you have any constructor? Yes, inside the class, do you have any constructor? Construct name class.
No, sir.
Any constructor is there inside the class? There is no constructor, right? Exactly. Yes, test t equal new test. After new keyword, this part is called constructor. But inside the class, do you have any constructor? Means there is no constructor, right? Up to last class, we didn't define any constructor basically. If you didn't define any constructor, guys, inside the class, the compiled is automatically generated zero argument constructor. Okay. What the point, guys? Inside the class, if you didn't define the constructor, the compiled is automatically generates what the zero argument constructor, guys. But compiler generated constructor is called a default constructor basically. Guys, compiler generated constructor is called which constructor? Default constructor, guys.
Default constructor.
So up to last class, inside the class, which constructor is generating here? Default constructor is generating. Default constructor is like zero argument constructor. Default constructor is zero argument constructor with the empty implementation, guys. There is no output basically. Which is what with the empty implementation, right? Exactly. Okay, this constructor is called which constructor here? This constructor default. Is called what? Default constructor, right? This is called default constructor. Who generate default constructor, guys? Compiler basically. Compiler checks for this constructor. Test t equal new test. After new keyword, this part is called constructor. Compiler checks for the constructor. There is no constructor. Then compiler immediately generate the constructor, right? Exactly. So generated by compiler, right? Exactly. How many argument constructor, guys? It is like zero argument constructor. Zero argument constructor with empty implementation, right? Empty implementation. That's what, there is no output anyhow. That is zero argument constructor. Yeah. So zero argument constructor with the empty implementations, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, are you clear now? This is called basically what concept here? Default constructor concept. So test t equal new test, after new keyword is called constructor, zero argument constructor. But up to last class also we didn't define any constructor inside the class. If we didn't define any constructor inside the class, then compiler generates which constructor, guys? You the compiler generates default constructor, right? Exactly, guys. Default constructor generated by compiler, which is like how many argument constructor? Zero argument constructor with empty implementation, right? Guys, zero argument constructor with the empty implementation, right? Exactly. But this is the code, guys. So if you run the code, you'll get the message simply good morning only. It's not a problem. So good morning is output, but we have to check the default constructor, right? Exactly. And basically the constructors are two types, guys. There are two types of constructors. Tell me, guys, what are the two types of constructors? There are two types of constructors. Guys, what are the two types of constructors? One is like default constructor. Yeah. Guys, one is the default constructor. One is the default constructor. The second one is what? User defined constructor, guys. User defined constructor, right? Exactly. Guys, there are two types of constructors basically. One is a default constructor. The second one is user defined constructor. Guys, who generate default constructor? Default constructors are generated by compiler, right? How many argument constructor is zero argument constructor with what implementation, guys? Here, empty implementation, right? Zero argument constructor with empty implementation, guys. User defined constructor means declared by user, right? Okay, so declared by developer, right? Declared by developer, guys. Depends on the developer requirement. He can declare either zero argument constructor or parameterized constructor, right? So he can declare zero argument or tell me, guys, zero argument or what? Params constructor, right? Params means what? Parameterized constructor, guys. Guys, are you clear now? So test t equal to new test, we are creating object. After new keyword, this part is called always constructor part. Yeah, this part is called always what? Constructor part. Rules to declare the constructor, what are the rules you have to follow? Constructor name, class name must be same. Constructor can take the arguments. Constructor return type not allowed, even void. This is basically constructor syntax. But up to last class, we didn't define any constructor. If we didn't define any constructor means, then compiler generates which constructor, guys, here? Default constructor, right? Exactly. So default constructor, how many argument constructor? It's like zero argument constructor with empty implementation, right? Exactly. So who generates default constructor means definitely compiler will generate the default constructor during compilation time, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, default constructor is clear, everyone?
Yes.
Good. The second one is which type, guys? Here, user defined constructor. The user defined constructor means declared by user, right? Okay. User defined constructor declared by user basically. So inside the class, let me declare my own constructors. Okay. Let me declare the constructor. What syntax tell me, guys? Constructor name, class name must be same. Open brace, closed brace. Here you can write the logic part, right? The system dot out dot println of. System dot out dot println of. Guys, this is how many argument constructor simply? Zero argument constructor, right? That's it. Guys, can I define one argument constructor? Tell me, guys, how can I define one argument constructor?
Test
construct name, class name must be same. Open brace, closed brace. Here the argument we have to specify. Integer A argument, right? Exactly. Guys, tell me here, this is like how many argument constructor it is?
One
argument constructor, right? Exactly. Okay, test T1 equal to new test of. Yeah, test T1 equal new test of. So after new keyword, this part is which part here? Constructor part, right? Constructor part means how many argument constructor it is basically? Zero argument, right? Zero argument means what happened, guys? This constructor will be executed or not?
Yes.
This constructor will be executed, right? Exactly. Can I create one more object like for the second constructor? So test T2 equal to, yeah, test T2 equal to what? New test of, test T2 equal new test of, here I can pass the argument, right? So this is like constructor, now this construct expecting how many arguments? One argument, right?
Right.
That's what here I'm passing the 10 value. Then this 10 will be stored in which variable here? A variable, right? Exactly, guys. So inside the class, just I declared two constructors. I'm calling those constructors, test T1 equal new test of zero argument. Test read equal new test of what? One argument, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, this case, what output now? Guys, what is output now?
Zero argument, one argument.
Yeah, simply it's printing like zero argument and one argument constructor, right? Exactly. Java code is compiled fine, code executed fine. Zero argument and one argument, right? It says like the constructors are, okay, constructors executed. Tell me, guys, when the constructor executed, construct is one special method to write the logic. Constructor is one special method to write the logic. These constructors are executed when we create the object, right? As constructor, we are calling are automatically executed when we create the object. When we create the object, it is automatically executed. Executed, right? Exactly. So, guys, today just to understand the declaration of the constructors and all. Tomorrow class will be important, guys. Tomorrow class will think about the real time how to use the constructors and how to use the variables, how to use the methods. Okay, this all we'll discuss in tomorrow class. So you'll get the complete clarity about the constructors, variables, methods and all in tomorrow class, guys. Tomorrow class will be important. Okay, good. So today, just to try to understand what is a constructor, how can we declare the constructor, what is a default constructor, what is the syntax of the constructor, that we will see today. Okay, good, guys. So example one is like case one is like this is the code. Yeah, case one is this is the code. So guys, the constructor is one special method basically. Constructor is a special method to write the logic. What is the advantage? I'll tell you tomorrow. Constructor is a special method to write the logics. When these logics executed, so these logics are executed. When we create the object, right? These logics are automatically executed when we create the object, right? Exactly, guys. Construct is one special method to write the logic. It's also just like a special method, guys, to write the logics. These logics are executed when we create the object, right? Exactly. And second point is like, see, guys, this is like zero default constructor or not? This is like zero argument constructor, right? Guys, this is the default constructor or not? I'm asking the question, this is the default constructor or not?
No, sir.
No. Yes. No, no, yes, sir.
No, it is user Sorry. Defined.
Yeah.
This is default constructor.
No, it's a user defined constructor, right? Default constructor means who will generate default constructor, man? The default constructor generated by compiler, right? Is it compiler generated or we declared? Oops.
We declared
means it's not a user defined constructor. Like this is not a
user defined
constructor. So only compiler generated constructor is called default constructor, guys. But user defined zero argument constructor is not a default constructor, right? So because default constructor is empty implementation, zero argument constructor is empty implementation, right? But here we have some implementation, right? Implementation means logic, right? Some logic is there. Good. What a conclusion, guys. Here. So. user defined so zero argument constructor, is not a default constructor. Well, what is the default constructor, guys? Only compiler generated constructor is called compiler generated constructor. Only compiler generated constructor is called default constructor, right? Exactly, guys. Is that point is clear? Java declared constructor is not a default constructor, guys. User defined zero argument constructor is not a default constructor. Only compiler generated constructor is called which constructor, guys? Default constructor, right? Exactly. Guys, default constructor inside the class visible mode or invisible mode? Default constructors inside the class visible mode or invisible mode? So
which is invisible mode. Is invisible.
It's invisible mode, right? Exactly. So it's basically like invisible mode, guys. But see, guys, one important point here. It's very, very important while doing the applications. But try to understand the point. I remove this constructor now. Discuss what's output now. So execution starts from main method. In the main method, test t1 equal to new test. After new keyword, this part is called which part here? Constructor part, right? This is how many argument constructor, guys? Zero argument constructor.
Zero.
But inside the class, do you have any zero argument constructor?
No.
No means what happened? Default constructor is generated, right?
Default will be called.
Exactly. Here default will be executed or not. Here default constructor is generated or not generated. Definitely it will generate, right? Maybe definitely will generate, guys. But if you compile this application, you'll get error message. Your default constructor will not generate, guys. Default constructor will not generate, right? So it's saying error message, constructor test is not, cannot be applied to the given types. So this is the issue. Test t1 equal new test. This is how many argument constructor, guys? Zero argument constructor is the issue, right? The reason is test t equal new test after new keyword, this is like zero argument constructor. Inside the class, there is no constructor means. Maybe you're thinking like default constructor is generated, guys. But the compiler will take the responsibility to generate default constructor only when we are not defined the constructor inside the class, guys. If you are not declaring any constructor, then only compiler take the responsibility. Once if you start defining the constructor, compiler never take the responsibility, guys. That's what even zero argument constructor, you have to define your own constructors. Guys, either compiler has to take the complete responsibility or user has to take the complete responsibility. Guys, that point is clear? Either compiler has to take the responsibility or what? User has to take the responsibility. Okay, both at a time not possible, guys. Both at a time not possible, right? Is that clear now? That's what here. Once we define one argument constructor, two argument constructor means, then your responsibility, we have to define all the constructors, required constructors, because compiler won't take any default constructor. If you are not define anything, then only compiler generates only default constructor. Either we have to take the responsibility completely or compiler has to take the responsibility, but both at a time not possible, guys. I can declare two constructor, compiler give the default constructor, both at a time not possible. Guys, are you clear now? This conclusion is very, very important, guys. Okay, so inside the class, so this is like case two definitely error. So what the error, guys? Default constructor generated or not generated? Default constructor not generated, right? Will not generate it, something like this. Fine, guys, this is the example. What a conclusion, guys, tell me here. So inside the class, if we are not declaring any constructor,
compiler will take, then compiler generates,
then compiler generates, then compiler generates what? Default constructor, right? Yeah, then compiler generates default constructor, guys. So inside the class, if you are not declaring any constructor, then only compiler generates what? Default constructor, guys. So inside the class,
sir, default constructor will be generated only for the empty constructor or for parameterized constructor as well.
Compiler generates only for the empty constructor. Default constructor means zero argument constructor only, not parameterized constructor.
Okay.
compiler is capable to generate only a zero argument constructor, guys.
Okay.
Even when it will generate, if you are not defined any constructor inside the class, if you define some constructors means, then compiler won't take any action, right? Compiler will not take the responsibility. Okay. It's fine, guys. Inside the class, once we declare the constructor, then what happened, guys? Inside the class, once we declare the constructor, compiler will not generate. Compiler will not generate default constructor, right? Exactly. Compiler will not generate the default constructor, guys. That is information. Yes, inside the class, if you are not declaring any constructor, then only compiler generate default constructor. Inside the class, once we declare the constructor, compiler will not generate the default constructor, right? Either you have to take the responsibility or compiler has to take the responsibility completely, but not both at a time, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, are you clear now? This conclusion is very, very important, guys. You try to focus on this conclusion, okay? Good, guys. So next example, you can see next example. One small conclusion, guys. Void wish method I can take. Void wish method. Definitely wish is instance method. How can we call this method? Using object, right? The system.out.println of. Yeah, this is only argument construct. This is like good morning message, right? Good morning message. Yeah, this is simply like good morning message. So test it equal new test, guys. What is the name of this object here? Guys, what is the name of this object there? The name of the object is T, right? Then you can call the T dot wish, right? Exactly. An object with a name, guys. An object which contains a name. That is called which approach, you know, named object approach, guys. An object with a name is called which approach here? Named object approach, right? Exactly. An object with a name is called which approach means nameless, named object approach. And even, so we can write the code with a nameless object, guys. Nameless object means you can call the new test dot directly. I can call the wish method. Tell me, guys, new test directly dot wish method I'm calling. Do you have this object contains any name here? Guys, this object contains any name. There is no name, right? Yeah, there is no name, right? Exactly. Then here, an object without name is called which object, guys, here? This is called nameless object. So I will tell you this, how when you use a named object, nameless object in tomorrow class, you try to understand first syntax here. Named object means what? An object with a name. An object contains a name is called named object. An object without name is called what? This is called what? Nameless. A nameless object, right? Exactly, guys. So named object and what? When we will use, how to use it, I'll tell you later. So nameless object, right? Exactly. So both cases will get the same output, guys. Right? But inside the class, do you have any constructor here? There is no constructor. There is no constructor means what happened, guys? I think this example generates a default constructor, right? Yeah, this example generates what? Default constructor, right? Exactly. Then code is compiled fine. So Java the class is called class, guys, here. Test class, right? We got the good morning is two times. So an object with the name is called named object. An object without name is called what? Nameless object, right? Exactly, guys. Named object means what? An object. An object with the name, right? Nameless object means what, guys? An object without name, guys. That's it. Guys, are you clear now? Good. So next example, last example you can take, constructor calling, guys. Because one method is calling another method, right? Like that way, same way, is that one constructor can call another constructor or not. Constructor can call another constructor or not means definitely it's possible, guys. One constructor can call another constructor. So here I have the one argument constructor, zero argument constructor, two argument constructor. Like this, I can take the three constructors here. Yeah, so like I can take this is like zero argument constructor. Yeah, this is a zero argument constructor. This is like one argument constructor. Here, can I take the two argument constructor? Total, I taken how many constructors here? Total here, three constructors, right? Zero argument constructor, one argument constructor, two argument constructor. Directly, I'm creating nameless object, new test assembly. So, see, this is just a variable name, right? This is a variable name. Without variable name, just I'm creating object, right? New test of 10. I'm creating new test of. Yeah, new test of what? 10 comma 20. Guys, this case would output now. This case, what is output now?
Zero
argument. Simply you get the output three lines, right? Zero argument constructor, one argument constructor, and what? Two argument constructor, right? Then code is compiled fine. So Java the classes, which class guys here? Test class. Zero argument constructor, one argument constructor, and what? Two argument constructor, right? We got the three constructors, guys. But I removed these two lines. Just I'm making new test. That's it. This line, what is output now? This line just will get the zero argument constructor, right? Just we are calling only zero argument constructor, right? Then code is compiled, code executed, zero argument constructor, guys. But the point is, while executing zero argument constructor, I want to call the one argument constructor. Then tell me, how can we call the one argument constructor while executing zero argument constructor? Yes, how can we call the one argument constructor? So while executing, this is like zero argument constructor. While executing this zero argument constructor, I want to call this one argument constructor, guys. How can we call this constructor? Basically, to call the constructor, we have to use the keyword like
this. Using this keyword.
This keyword you have to use. This keyword is used to call the constructors basically. Okay, this of how many argument constructor I want to call? I want to call this is like one argument constructor, right? So then we have to pass the this of corresponding argument here. The argument will be the 10, right? This of 10. This of 10 means it is calling how many argument constructor? One argument constructor, right? Exactly. In the same way, here I can call the I want. Now this case, what is output now, first of all? Guys, this case, what is output now? I'm calling zero argument constructor, and zero argument constructor is calling like one argument constructor. Then what is output now?
One argument constructor and zero argument constructor.
Yeah, first you got the one argument constructor and what? Then zero argument constructor, right? Exactly. So then here, while executing one argument constructor, I want to call the two argument constructor, 10 comma 20. Then this case, what is output now?
Two arg, one arg, zero arg.
Yeah, you get the output is like code is compiled fine, code executed fine. Two arg, one arg, zero argument, right? Exactly, guys. Simply to call the constructors, what is the keyword we are using here? Simply we are using this keyword, right? Exactly. That is the case one. So to call the constructors, use keyword, guys. Use this keyword, right? Use this keyword, guys. And if we take the case two now, case two, I remove this keyword here, I place it here somewhere. In this case, what is output now? I remove this keyword here, I place this keyword here. Guys, this case, what is output now?
01.
In this case, the output will be what?
It will generate an error message, sir.
Why? Guys, this
the
generates error.
Constructor must be first.
Okay, fine. So, this example generates error messages, guys. The reason is, inside the constructor, only inside the constructor, guys. This rule is applied only inside the constructor. Inside the constructor, this keyword should be first statement. Guys, inside the constructor, this keyword should be first statement, right? This is called constructor. In the constructor, this keyword must be first statement, guys. But is it first statement or second last other statements, other okay. statement, right? Yeah, it's not allowed, guys. So what the conclusion here? Inside the only inside the constructor, guys. Inside the constructor. This keyword must be first statement, right? Exactly. This keyword must be first statement, right? Yeah, inside the constructor, this keyword must be first statement, guys. So guys, if we take the case three now, so can I use two this keywords in the first place itself? So here this keyword is there. I remove this keyword here, I place this keyword here. Is it valid or invalid now? Guys, it's valid or invalid?
Invalid, sir.
Invalid, valid, invalid means definitely is invalid because the two these keywords are not allowed, guys. Because this keyword must be first statement, right? This keyword must be first statement means first one is a first statement, it's not a problem. But second one is not in the first statement, right? Exactly. So in this case, inside the constructor, how many these keywords are allowed only? As inside the constructor, only one this keyword is allowed. Inside the constructor, only one this keyword is allowed means one constructor can call how many constructors then? Yes, inside the constructor, only one this keyword is allowed, right? So inside the constructor, only one this keyword is allowed. Then one constructor can call how many constructors? Only one constructor, right?
Only one constructor.
Yeah. Then what a point, guys, here? One method can call how many methods at a time? One method can call multiple methods, right? Guys, one method can call the multiple methods. Because inside the main method, you are calling like multiple methods, right? One method can call multiple methods. But one constructor can call? One constructor can call
only one constructor.
Yeah, one constructor can call only one constructor, right? Exactly, guys. One constructor can call only one constructor. guys, are you clear? Yeah, that's all for the today class, guys. Just you try to check these notes. So constructor means like test t equal new test after new keyword at part is college part, guys, constructor part. So rules to declare the constructor name class name must be same. So how can we create the object means using new keyword, guys. New is a keyword basically. Using new keyword will create the object. Okay, so rules to declare the constructor, guys. Constructor name class name must be same. So constructor can take the arguments. Constructor return type is allowed or not allowed means. Constructor return type is allowed or not allowed. Return type is not allowed, even void also not allowed, right? Exactly, guys. Maybe you can ask the one question like class versus object, guys. Tell me, guys, what is the define the class versus object? Class versus object, the first point, guys. Define the class. What do you make class, guys? Class is a define the class. What is the class? Class is simply can say, so see, guys, inside the class, what we are writing, simply writing the logics, right? Simply inside the class, we are writing the logics means I can say like class is a logical entity, right?
Class is a logical entity.
Exactly. Class is a logical entity, guys. Class is a logical entity contains what and logics of the application or not. Yes or no? The first point is what? Yes. Class is a logical entity. Okay, logical entity contains. Contains what? Right. Contains logics of the logics of the application, right? Exactly. Guys, what about object? Tell me here. What about object here? Object is a logical entity, physical entity.
Object is a physical entity.
Physical entity, right? Physical entity represents what? Represents the memory basically.
The memory.
When you create the object, think like you are creating memory, guys. Unnecessarily, if you are creating object means unnecessarily you are creating memories. It allocate the memory, right? Basically. Allocate the memory, right? Exactly. So class is a logical entity, guys, contains logics of the application. Object is a physical entity represents what? Represents the memory, right? Represents the memory, guys. And second point is like class is the blueprint. So based on the class only we are creating object, right? Without class, can we create this object here? Definitely we cannot create the object, right? Exactly. So what the point is here? Class is blueprint decides object creation, right? So without class, can we create the object? Yes, without class, not possible to create the object, right? Definitely by using class only creating object, right? So without class, not possible to create the object, right? Exactly, guys. The second point. Tell me, guys, based on the single blueprint, single class. See, if you take the civil engineer, before constructing building, he will create the blueprints, right? Based on the blueprint only, we can construct the building. So based on the single blueprint, he can construct only one building. Are in multiple buildings in multiple areas. Same blueprint is there. You can construct a Madhapur same building, Hitech City same building, Amirpet same building. Some how many blueprints you have? Only one blueprint you have. How many constructors? How many buildings he constructed? Multiple places, right? Multiple buildings, right? Yeah. Single blueprint you can create the multiple objects, guys. But every object needs some space, right? Every building is need some space or not? Which is nothing but a memory, guys, basically. Which is nothing but what? Memory. Okay. Which is nothing but what? Memory, right? Exactly. Then what are the conclusion, guys? Yeah. So based on the single blueprint, based on the single class, so it is possible to create. Tell me, guys, it is possible to create. Yeah, it is possible to
multiple objects.
It is possible to create the multiple object, right? It is possible to create the multiple objects. Come on. Every object required what? Guys, every object needs memory, right?
Memory.
Exactly, guys. Every need memory space, basically, you can say. Every object needs memory space, right? Exactly, guys. So based on the single class, you can create the multiple object, guys. But every object needs what? Memory space, right? Exactly. Guys, how to define the class? Declare the class using which keyword? Declare the class using class keyword. How to create the object, guys, here? So create the object using which keyword here?
New keyword,
right? Exactly. We have 4 points, basically. So class is a logical entity, contains logics, because variables and methods constructed is all used to write the logics on, right? That's what you can say. Class is a logical entity, contains what? Logics of the application. Object is what, guys? Object is a physical entity, represents what? Memory, right? And class is a blueprint, it decides object creation. Without class, not possible to create the object, right? and based on a single class it is possible to create based on a single class possible to create one object, multiple objects. Every object needs what? Every object needs memory space, right? And declare the class using class keyword and create the object using which keyword here? New keyword, right? Exactly, guys. I hope you got the clarity about default constructors and user defined constructors, named object versus nameless object, named object versus nameless object, and a constructor. To call the constructor, we are using this keyword, right? And this keyword should be first statement. And one constructor can call how many constructors, guys? Only one constructor, right?
One constructor.
Exactly. Is any question?
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Tell me.
I have one doubt.
Tell me.
What is the difference between class and abstract class, sir?
That I'll tell you as part of abstract classes concept, because abstract class is it doesn't allow you to create the object. Abstract classes is not possible to create the object. That I'll tell you that time, okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, just one, tell me.
Yes, sir. I mean, between the name class and unnamed class, unnamed object and named object, we have, when while creating an object, like test is a class, test t is equal to new test. So if I say test t and semicolon, test, and you say you have just, yes, you have just mentioned that, sir, that it creates an object, t defines an object. I mean, if I write test t is equal to new test, t is becomes an object. So what if, sir, if I write test t,
t is just object name of the object,
name of the object. And if I write test t semicolon, then sir, what is t in that case?
That is a name. You fix it for one name, okay? You have to assign some object to that name, right? Is something like, you decide one name for your kid, newborn kid, like next month your delivery is there, just you decided some name, right? First, initially you decided name. When the kid is born, then you can assign that name to the kid, right? It's a kind of like that.
Okay. Basically, the object has not been created, but we have just...
You decided name first. Decided
the name.
But with that name, you can't, in no use, right? You decided just name. When the child is born, then you can give that name to that child. They know that name is meaningful, right?
Okay. I got it.
Sir. No, tell me.
When an object is created, some memory space is allocated. How it decides how much memory space should be allocated?
But Jamie will take care about that memory allocations.
And so one more thing, sir. We have discussed the static variables also. Okay. So, sir, I want some kind of example which states that static variable does not change.
Yeah, that's tomorrow. I'll discuss in the real time how to use a static, how to use instance. Tomorrow I'll give the example. That's what I said, tomorrow class.
Yes. Okay.
Guys, any other questions, please?
No, sir.
Sir, give some assignments to work on.
Yes, tomorrow, sir. Tomorrow. We need some assignments.
Tomorrow I'll give the assignment. This is all a declarations, right? I say I cannot give any assignment today with her. Today what I done declaration part, right? All of syntaxes and declarations, right? Tomorrow when you give the example, then I'll give the assignment definitely.
Okay, sir.